know that God is one way.
Lala.
Whoa! What title do we give that movie?
This has been exactly
the same movie in other parts of the country.
Oh my goodness!
But for Henry,
it was a weekend full of tension.
It was a weekend full of drama, chaos.
In every corner.
A lot.
Oh my goodness! Did you see the lady there? In a yellow dress?
Women are busy fighting. You guys. That was what happened in the Mbale district as the NRM, over the NRM primaries, of course, as Lydia Wanyoto battled it out with Connie Galiwango there. And of course, we are yet to receive official results. Isn't that so?
Sure, we haven't received any official results from the party.
What we know is that some people are leading, others are losing, obviously.
This is putting us on tension, especially those that were contesting.
But Henry, was that called for? Was that we just watched called for? Is it something really?
It's not something that is called for, but when you look at the money that these guys invest in, so in a way it pushes them to do what you have seen them do, that they have to fight to that extent of, almost killing each other.
It is so hilarious. Hey, my goodness. I can't stand. But you guys, that is just exactly what happened in Mbale. Of course, that was after the voting, and preliminary results still show that Connie Galiwango is in the lead after beating Lydia Wanyoto. But that's just those preliminary results.
Yeah, we haven't received confirmation.
Yes, they haven't, showed us the final results of what happened in the NRM Kamiufu. That aside from Lydia Wanyoto and, of course, ministers, we've seen ministers, we've seen current members of parliament,
the big wigs,
beaten, hands down, properly.
But to me, the most interesting one was the Koboko one.
Tell me about Evelyn Anite.
The gateway.
Whoa! Eh? Oh.
The gateway to Koboko. Oh my goodness. What happened to the gates? I don't know.
I don't know. I really don't know what happened, what went wrong. No, Henry, you interact with these people more than we do. What do you think went wrong?
There's only one thing, and most of them have ignored it. Because, when they get those 5 years, they think all is done. They forget that at one point, after the end of these 5 years, they will go back to their electorate. And that's for another mandate, for the next 5 years. So if you ask me what really happened, I look at only that one thing, that these people, when they're elected into office, appointed ministers, they tend to forget about the electorate, the people that vote into these offices.
Yes, indeed. Henry, look at Anita's supporters.
Bambi. I saw them crying, men,
There's
women,
a man
old
who
women.
Undressed properly and started crying. It was so painful. I didn't know elections were that painful.
Because I imagine they're very hopeful that, this one we are taking it home. But then at the end of the day, they come out.
Okay, so if you cry, then what happens?
I don't know. They're trying to sympathize with their minister.
It's okay to sympathize, but must you cry? If you cry, then what? So
it doesn't solve anything.
It doesn't absolutely solve anything. Mm.
But that was very bad.
Anyway, a quick one. Some of the ministers that were, alleged. Because we do not have the final results, these are the names of the ministers who have not, according to preliminary results, who, did not make it up. Mm. Ministers Evelyn Anite of Investment, Elieda Tumwesije Technology, Adolf Tumwesije Defense, Mary Karoro Cruz General Duties, Michael Warike Trade, Mwesigwa Rukutana Labor, and Christopher Chibanzanga Veteran Affairs. Those are some of the ministers that were, of course, trounced over the weekend.
Do we have Beatrice Anywa here?
Oh, yes, we should add her.
Oh,
there.
She's not here. Beatrice Anywa, I remember she just crossed over from FDC and then joining NRM. Was this a rejection?
Terrible. Listen.
Was this a rejection or something? I don't know what will happen.
Listen, what I have learned about voters in these elections is that they know what they want. Oftentimes, they take advantage of the aspirants. Because they are desperate for votes.
That's true.
They'll do just about anything. Like we saw with somebody who was like, who was told to dig a grave so he can get to vote.
So they can do
but
anything. They're told
to
do.
How that person performed.
We need to find out.
Come here,
you may find it's one of those that lost.
Absolutely. So there you are, voters, you know, showing exactly what you want. And guess what? You can join the conversations on social media. That is at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter. Lynn Komjisha, and that is at Lynn UG3 on Twitter, at Seka Henry on Twitter. And then go to Facebook, Urban Television, Seka Henry, Lynn Komjisha. Let us know what your thoughts are on the just concluded election, the NRM primaries.
At least it's a chilly morning, so if you're still at home, you can pick a sweater, you know, a jacket, before you head out to Kampala.
Talk about, this is weather, this is baby making weather. Those of you who are single, everyone here is taken. Jesus.
Enoch is still
searching. Maybe Enoch and Andrew. So guys, if you're still in your beds, it's okay. Switch on the TV and we will be making constructive noise for you as you also get busy. If you're not busy or if you're not, it's okay. Please join in on the conversation. Ministers, members of parliament have been trounced. And then today, the president, who is also the chairman of the NRM, is going to hold a meeting at the party headquarters. But most importantly, he's going to give out motorcycles to sub-county chiefs.
I think he launched the project.
This he's going to actually give out motorcycles to party sub-county chairpersons, and then a detailed brief of what transpired during the party primaries also be provided to him.
I'm so looking forward to what he's going to tell the party members. Because most of them have come out to, okay, they're not on record, but most of them have come out to blame him for the chaos and
I know,
the
music. Been blamed.
Because apparently people like Anita have said that the win in Koboko municipality is not for the party. Because she said this is an opposition win that apparently most of the guys that voted, you know, for Dr. Charles Ayume were from the opposition. And that is because the party chairman, His Excellency President Yoweri Museveni, allowed, you know, NRM party members that are not in the register to vote.
So are you saying that the opposition, because they were allowed, anyone was allowed to vote, also, you know, took over the chance and... But there's why I saw kids lining up.
Yeah. By the way, Anita also talked about it, that even kids were allowed to vote.
There were kids of as young as 5 years.
That was really bad. So that shows you that was some bit of mess.
Well,
the entire process.
Absolutely. And so some coordinators argue that in some areas, police delayed to deploy. And even when they did, the officers were not enough to cool off the tempers. There was drama. Several attempts to alter the results in favor of the powerful, but it also did not work out. So those are some of the things that we saw in the NRM primaries. Also, interestingly, before we can move away from the primaries, Rwengo polling officials are in hiding.
What did they do?
Now, these ones, they took off. Allegedly, they're being intimidated.
Okay.
They're being threatened because you guys.
So, of course, there's no way, you know, you can free without, you know, making, maybe they made some bit of mistakes here and there. They tampered with the, you know, the results.
They tampered with the voters register, perhaps. We do not know what exactly they did, but they're in hiding. They're scared.
Does that mean that they are going to repeat the entire, you know, we're going to have a rerun in Rengo? Because if the
If they have run away, that means they have not tallied the votes.
Exactly, yeah.
So, it means, lots of questions. Lots of questions. Now, as we wind up on that topic, Henry, Nope. Last week we saw that the National Unity Platform people were saying we're going to choose our you know, party mm-hmm. flag bearers.
Sure.
Now, after the NRM primaries, like, no, we are not going to miss out on this chance. So what they are doing is that they're going to actually hold party primaries in highly contested areas. That is in areas of the, where the NRM had, you know, contestations.
Mm.
And what are they saying? They're saying those who got who were defeated by a small margin of votes.
That they can join their party?
They're going to sweet talk them. Sweet talk. Imagine sweet talking Evelyn and it.
I know. And America recruit to join.
I know. How do you do that?
I don't see it happening at all.
So they're going to sweet talk them and perhaps hold primaries in those particular.
But away from, you know, sweet talking the opposition, rather the guys in the NRM, it's a good thing. Because at first, you know, I looked at it as something that's going to, you know, going to affect democracy. Because, I mean, if you just come out and say that I'm going to pick so and so to stand in a certain constituency, you deny the people a chance.
Absolutely, yes.
You know, to pick those that I think should represent them. So
mm-hmm.
it's a good thing, it's a good move on their side, and it's a welcome idea.
Mm-hmm. Well, we look forward to how that plays out for Noop guys. Now, away from the party primaries, still, relatedly, honestly. The Criminal Investigations Department Director, that is Grace Akulo, has taken over a Rukutana shooting accusation. And she has actually camped down in Mbarara.
To investigate what usually happened.
Absolutely. She's investigating. But Henry, there are interesting accounts, different accounts of what happened.
Mm.
One he shot, one he did not. Which one is which? But that
did you look
was
at
hit
that video?
By stones, not
okay, in the video, they don't show us that what he was shooting.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but we see him
holding
his gun.
A gun. Yeah. So really don't. Maybe with the investigations, they'll be able to tell us what will happen. But with the videos that we have, you know, moving around social media, it shows that he had a hand somewhere.
Anyway, that is what happened. So the case involves Rukutana and Ray Virunji. Now, Ray Virunji is thought to be an FDC person. And like they've been alleging, I don't know how true these allegations are, but we've had several NRM people say that the opposition, in a way, had a hand in what was going on, especially with the electoral violence. So they're saying that somehow these things are fueled by the opposition. Now, in this case, the people who, of course, the witnesses there, eyewitnesses say that this gentleman, Ravenge, was, you know, beaten.
But what was Ravenge
doing?
Was
he shot? Was he beaten? What?
What was he doing in an election? Because he's opposition.
What was he doing? So was he supposed to be home? What if he was going his own way?
Something's fishy there.
Exactly. So that is why Grace Akulo is down in Mbarara, carrying out investigations there. But that's not the only case she's investigating. She's also investigating a case in Isinjiro District where two people were actually shot.
Mm.
They were shot and during, of course, the electoral period as you know, the primaries went on. So Rukutana was arrested on Saturday and he's still in, you know, custody. We hope to see that, you know, come to an end and find out exactly what happened.
Mm-hmm. Because they're denying the accusations.
As usual. But anyway, we wait to see what happens there. Moving away, yes, from the NRM primaries. Henry.
Yeah.
Please, gentlemen and ladies, you're in your bed. Can you please, in all your plans, in everything you do, as you plan for your day, have a mask, have a hand sanitizer. If you cannot afford one like myself, just buy a Chitoli Sabuni Blue.
And get your hands clean.
A bar of soap. Keep cutting Kalito, put in your pocket. Whenever you're going and you find water, wash your hands.
That's true.
Guys, wash your hands. Do you know what is happening in the country? Kampala, in the last few months, has registered 1,308 community infections.
That is worrying.
That is very
And
dangerous.
You know what happened during the NRM primaries? People were not observing the SOPs.
Now imagine after 2 weeks, what cases we shall we'll be having. I don't want to, you know, speculate, but we have seen that whenever there is a crowd gathering, after some time,
the cases, you know, tend to go on.
Soar up. Mm. So surely something needs to be done. Now, Uganda total cases as of now stand at 3,667. Total deaths are 41 and recoveries are 1,564. But not in the last few months altogether, that is between March and now.
Up to date, yeah.
Kampala, central Kampala. Kampala, as you hear it, has recorded 1,308. And this is in districts of Mukono, Wakiso. There's another one I forget that got out of my head. But those are the country, those are the districts that are heavily.
And Lynn was worrying about this, about over, when you look at the 1,300 cases, about 467 people haven't been evacuated.
Exactly, yes.
Meaning they're still in the community.
They're still in the community, they're still in their homes.
Yeah, this means that we still they're still infecting other people.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there is the cases are likely to go up, really.
And they're saying that there's need for new quarantine centers as we continue, of course, to register, you know, cases in Kampala. Kampala allegedly, not alleged, is still a hotbed, you know.
Yeah, it's an epicenter.
To become. Mm. And somehow, the elections have overtaken, you know, the coronavirus situation. So somehow we have, you know, gotten into the election period and we are forgetting.
And no one is minding about the SOPs.
Yes, no one is caring about the SOPs. So people, please, a quick reminder. I'm going to remind you, wear your mask right. You wear your mask here.
It doesn't help.
Do you have a nose and mouth here? Do you? Do you? Is there a mouth here and a nose? No. Nose is here, mouth is here. Cover up. It's for your own good. It's for your family.
Lynn, some people, you know, take it as a punishment. That wearing a mask is a punishment. So some of them end up, you know, putting it under their chin.
Actually, others put it behind the back. Others put it on top here. Who are you? Anyway, you fall sick. Remember, you have to pay for that test. Remember, you have to pay for your well-being in the hospital if you're admitted. Guys, think through these things and stop misbehaving. Like you're not doing it for anyone. You're doing it for yourself. Well, enough of the ranting about coronavirus. People still don't take it serious. But trust me, the day it will get to you, you will know.
They'll get serious about
you
it.
You will know.
Mm.
Well, elsewhere in the world, Henry, Mali's ousted leader flies to United Arab Emirates after a stroke. Now, we saw earlier that the Malian leader, that is Ibrahim Boubacar Keita, beg your pardon, was toppled by his, you know, his people.
Sure.
And his government resigned, and they instituted some transition, which is there. They wanted to be in power for about 3 years. They were told, no, you have 1 year. So there's a lot that has been going on, and then he took ill. So on taking ill, he needed, of course, you know, specialized treatment, and so he went to United Arab Emirates. So Mr. Keita, 75, flew to the United Arab Emirates Saturday for medical treatment after suffering a minor stroke. The junta is currently in talks with opposition and civil society groups about a transition to civilian rule. He says it will step down in 2 years, but West African leaders want a quicker transfer of power, which is, I think, very...
Yeah.
Yeah, very
to
okay.
Bring peace, you know.
Yeah.
It's very important.
It's very, very, very important. Absolutely. So Mr. Keita was overthrown on 18th August. We saw that happening. We actually brought you those stories here. Following mass protests against his rule over corruption, mismanagement of the economy, and a dispute over legislative elections.
Of course, he was detained by the military, but later freed. And on Thursday, he left a hospital in the capital, Bamako, after a two-day stay during which he was treated for a minor stroke. And his former chief of staff said he could be away for up to 15 days.
Absolutely. Mr. Keita left for the United Arab Emirates capital after representatives of the regional body, ECOWAS, and the United Nations held talks with coup leaders. And ECOWAS gave an undertaking to the junta that Mr. Keita would return if he is wanted for any crimes allegedly committed during his seven-year rule. And in its fourth coup in the West African state since it gained independence from France. Jesus.
I know.
Coups everywhere.
They never stop in Africa.
Yes, yes, absolutely. So that's what's happening in Mali. We keep you updated, of course, on what is coming up and how things will play out as we see Ibrahim Boubacar Keïta, if he returns to the country, if he has any crimes against humanity that they want to try him over, they're expecting him. We'll take a breather right now and return with Press Digest. This is what's happening in the press now today in the New Vision. Please, if you have not gotten yourself a copy of the New Vision, just so you know, it is on the market and is at only 2,000 Uganda shillings. But get yourself the New Vision digital experience application on Google Play Store, on on iOS. That is an Apple Store as well. Please just get yourself that application. You don't know what you're missing out on. Now, here in the New Vision, CID boss takes over recruit and a shooting case. Will NRM team win back Kampala?
That's a very
interesting one to look for. Mm-hmm. To look forward to, yeah? Well, we'll wait to see. Ministry of Health explains COVID-19 results variations. CID director, of course, there's a detailed story there. Police to recruit over 5,000 constables. Yamal. What are you waiting for? See what they're looking for in today's New Vision. Now, the government has directed humanitarian NGOs to validate permits. Find out what they're talking about. Examining glitches in the NRM primaries. Yes, indeed. We'll see how that plays out. Luengo polling officials in hiding. The detailed story. Get it? I can imagine there are others we don't know about.
Sure.
10 held over Zimbabwe poll violence. Namuganza speaks out on council. Namuganza is back in the news. Okay, we move on. Motherhood, the challenges of raising boys. In Pakasa, today is Monday. Don't forget, Pakasa is in here. How Nantongo fell for passion. Find out how she did it. There's also a video version of this, so please get yourself a copy of the New Vision as well as the New Vision Digital Experience app, and you'll definitely have everything at your fingertips. Let's pass O-level. Yes, don't miss out on what's happening in Pass O-level. In business, when you want to sell your business, insurers urge to seize COVID-19 opportunities. Yeah, there's so much more. There are jobs. Trump cracks down on anti-racism trainings. There's so much more. Now, also, being a Mandy, we have the health and beauty pullout. Yes, your wellness guide. Mental health and suicide. By the way, suicide is a serious problem. And it's been on the rise since the lockdown. In sport, goalkeeping crisis looming at Cranes. Find out. I feel more than ready. Who is saying so? Get yourself a copy of the New Vision.
Okay, butele mbuke de uruna kuruwale, iroku nusuru kumiro kaya tuseda kukatale. Wandiba dogi na nama wangu inolaba, vichive wandise kuona kuruwale iro. Bakulembeza mtuwe kugamba nti abawanguddwa balaze chebazzaako tuogera ku kamyufu ka NRM. Balaze chebazzaako era olukalala lw'abawanguddwa mu Buganda naduli alaze engeri akamyufu ka NRM jekakubiddwa. Era tulaba nti Bobi Wine alidde matereke ne jeno Eric Kayanja mu katabo akabukedde kona kulwa leero. Abadde yeesimbyewo ku bwa Lord Kansala afudde mawulire makyamu nnyaawo. Owa boda boda bamusse mu ntiisa byonna birimbukedde wonna ku lwaleero. Abawanguddwa mu NRM bawanda muliro. Era tulaba nti bakulaga ensonga ezawanguza abaka ba Buganda 19 bazikuleetedde mu kataba kakabukedde wali kaguza n'obanga osoma ebisingako. Nalikyali bukedde wonna ku lwaleero. Lutamaguzi alojja ennaku yekkomera. abiwandiseko wano eno mu katabo kakabukedde Bobby ne Kayanja balidde matereke biji nyo ebiri mu katabo kakabukedde owona ku lwaleero mulimu ebyokusoma by'ekibiina kya P6 ne P7 nga teyatuzeeyo ku by'emizannyo tulaba nti Portugal, Bungereza ne Bufalansa zitandise na buwanguzi Crazy Africa fomu y'abazanyi ngebula ennaku 5-5 batunkene South Sudan yeraliikiriza biji nyo muvukedde olunaku lwaleero wegulie ku nusu lukumi lwa kaloka osombe ebisingawo.
Absolutely, that is in Bukedde at only 1,000 shillings and the New Vision 2,000 Uganda shillings. You can also subscribe to our e-papers. You'll get access to all these papers just at the tip of your fingers. Now, Henry, for the people who lost in the primaries, as we wait for the official results.
Hopefully they come out today.
Maybe they shouldn't lose hope. They should be. I feel so sorry for them. Well, this is why we have an inspiring quote for you today. We are thinking about you and we understand what you're going through. Please, there is no secret to success. It is the result of preparation, hard work, and learning from failure. Mm-hmm. So it is not the end of the road.
They can still make it.
They can still make it. Work hard, work.
Hard work pays, right?
Yes.
So they should prepare for it. Yeah?
They shouldn't lose hope. Some of them are stressed.
You're telling them to wait till 2026.
Yes.
Because for now they have no chance.
Hang on, pray hard, work
prepare
hard
for 2026.
Yes, and you know, be positive about life. Don't lose it. Eh? Please, you will make it in future. Don't worry. We'll take a break right now. And we come back with what's happening. We look at exactly what is going on and how are we going to address this.
In the New Vision this Monday, are you searching for your dream job? New Vision brings you hundreds of opportunities. Get a copy today. As the country heads for general elections, will NRM team win back Kampala? After the NRM primaries, what are the glitches? What went wrong? What went right? And where are the learning points for the forthcoming general elections? Get the stories in this Monday New Vision. Minister Rukutana's woes have gone deeper after the CID boss decided to take over his case. Get the details in the New Vision. If you had a dream of joining the police, here's an opportunity for you. Get a copy of the New Vision. Over 400 COVID-19 cases are still at home as Kampala registers 1,308 community infections. What is the way forward? Get New Vision. After nearly 6 months of lockdown, national parks are due to open for tourists. Find the story in your copy of the New Vision. Ruwengo poll officials are in hiding. Find out why. The Health Ministry has explained why there are variations in the COVID-19 results. Get the explanation in the New Vision. These and so many more in your copy of this Monday New Vision.
New Vision. New Vision.